Right, let's go talk to some other people.
It is done.
Do mine eyes deceive me? Alive and well, hale and hearty. Belos must have been furious to see you walk out of the arena after your most recent victory. His mask is slipping.
I will keep pushing him until he finally breaks.
I want to believe you will continue to prevail, but I have been disappointed in the past. If you rise up to challenge Baylor, I will be the first to cheer your name when he falls.
What do you mean, to challenge Baylor?
A few months back, a group defeated all 15 of Baylor's prepared entertainments. Infuriated by the champion's success, Baylor entered the pits to face him himself.
Really? He acts like this never happened before, like we never defeated so many. How did that work out for them?
As you can see, Baylor is still here. If you sift the sand in the black pits thoroughly, you may turn up some bits of the former champions.
You sure know how to encourage a woman.
If you two manage to overcome all of his other entertainments, you may still find Baylor more than you can handle. Be sure to hone your skills and equip yourself as well as possible before that time comes.
There has to be some other way to escape. Isn't there? Okay.
Do mine eyes deceive me? Alive and well, hail and
hearty. Cousin Thardak looks nervous these days.
I have noticed the same. Sometimes I wonder why Thardak was nowhere to be seen when Baylor first attacked. He showed up only after the battle, almost as if he expected. No, I cannot bear to think that.
What are you thinking?
By the time Thardak returned, much of the clan was slain, the rest enslaved. His reaction seemed forced, almost as if he was pretending to be surprised. When Belos turned toward him, he knelt at once.
Well, that could mean anything. Maybe he's just a coward. Still, thanks for the tip. Okay, so now we got chainmail plus 2. Plate of the Dark, plus 1. Dark Lord Hurtius, undead warlord of Bane, wore this piece of armor for over 500 years. During this time, he was rumored to dwell in a castle somewhere within the Earthfast Mountains. How his armor moved to other lands without him is not certain, though the separation of the two was surely unpleasant. Armor class 0, with minus 4 versus slashing, minus 3 versus piercing and missile. Requires 15 strength, and technically we can afford it, but not really. Okay, so we got medium shields, we've been using large shields. Pelen shield, plus 2. This shield was commissioned from the finest dwarven smiths by Pelen of Tyr, a renowned paladin who was known for his unquestioning courage and total lack of common sense. Upon hearing that a red dragon was ravaging the countryside, Pelen mounted his horse and rode off to do battle. Pelen and his armor digested readily, but the shield gave the dragon severe stomach cramps. He coughed it up, and it lay in his treasure pile for several years until it was retrieved by Pelen's son, a paladin who knew when to sneak. The superior craftsmanship is supplemented by a permanent lightness spell which makes the shield very easy to wield. Okay, armor class plus 3, extra plus 1 versus missile attacks. So, we get an extra plus 3 for this. Okay, so she's using a regular Medium, regular large shield, I mean. Switching to large shield plus one. Armor class zero now. Well, should she use Pelan's shield and have them... Yeah. Have the cleric use this. Negative two. Look at that. So I get negative one, one, and negative two. That's pretty awesome.
I am here. It is done.
A pittance. All right.
It is done.
Hello.
You continue to astonish us with your victories.
You continue to astonish Magda with your refusal to talk with her. What happened?
Master, there is a matter requiring your attention in the Room of Pain.
Ah, already? I expected this one to hold out much longer. Well, any time is a good time for pain.
What's going on?
This could be a trick, but I may never have another chance. Belos knows how much I depend on Magda for support during this ordeal. His idea of the perfect torment was to promise he would kill one of my people if I spoke so much as a word to Magda. And he threatened to kill another for every additional word I spoke to her. He knew my silence would infuriate her too, torturing us both in one wicked stroke.
But he didn't warn you against speaking to anyone else, right? I could pass along a message.
That's right. You could tell her the truth for me.
I'll think about it. It's much funnier to watch you struggle. I don't have the option to tell him yes. Only that I'll think about it. Okay.
You continue to astonish us with your victories.
Alright, let me look at what you have. Telbar studded leather, plus two. This armor was the property of the famous rogue Telbar. How or why it left his possession is not known. Armor class five, alright. Just pricey, of course. Small shield, plus two. Alright. Here's Magda.
You sure are getting under Baeloth's skin. If only our Durgar men had showed such spirit when Baeloth attacked us. Do you need any new weapons for the fight?
Well, listen, Magda. Brendak isn't ignoring you by choice. Baeloth threatened to kill one Durgar for every word Brendak speaks to you.
What? He suffered the brunt of my anger all this time in silence. But he was only trying to protect the rest of the survivors.
He's not the only one who suffered. You're welcome.
You sure are getting under Baeloth. What? He suffered the brunt of my anger all this time in silence. You sure are getting... What? He suffered
That's
the brunt
okay.
of my anger all this time in silence.
Battle Axe of Molotor.
But he was only trying to protect the rest of the survivors.
Alright, I'll read this. During the Tartharian Civil War, the Battle Axe of Molotor was in the possession of the House of Asiand. The noble family was betrayed while trying to flee the country, and Molotor, lead guard and personal friend, took up the axe and sacrificed himself to buy enough time for his companions to flee. His battle cry was favored by the gods, and was echoed across the lands as a symbol of devoted friendship and loyalty. Thus, the magical axe was used to uphold these virtues against those who lacked honor and courage. Unless I'm not going to use it. Should we get her a flail? Plus two? Oh no, she's good in mace and warhammer. Some of these weapons are pretty interesting looking. Sariris's blade plus two. Sariris, a white minotaur who traveled the Osron Mountains in Termish, lived for nothing but the thrill of combat and encouraged warriors to challenge him for his magical weapon, a powerful halberd. Despite his aggressive nature, he was an honorable combatant and never slew opponents he could overpower. Sariris met his superior only once in a battle that lasted hours and had the minotaur often fearing defeat. The contest ended when his opponent's sword broke, but Sariris knew he likely would have been bested had it continued. He presented his weapon to the astonished man, who thereafter told of this noble creature to anyone who would listen. Alright. We got mace plus two. Ashadina plus two. Lady Ashadina was a remarkable strategist who honed her skills against the orc armies in the Year of the Black Horde. She met Durgat Wiltoon, the warrior that wielded this weapon, when he foiled an ambush led by the great orc Varstok, and soon after made him her field captain. After serving at each other's side for the entirety of the war, they fell in love and eventually married. Historians report that Durgat named his warhammer after his bride to remind himself of the love he fought to protect. What Lady Ashadina thought of this is unknown. Okay, so it's a warhammer. Okay, good. 1d4 plus 3 with plus 1 electrical damage. Yeah, I think I'm gonna get this for her. It's not that much. 2-handed sword plus 2. Okay, she needs a magical weapon. In fact, let's look at our Thaco. 14. So, and he's using yes. What? Two-handed sword plus one. So if we get him a plus two, that'd be even better, of course.
Yes, indeed.
Thinking about it.
I am here.
Let's talk to him and then go buy some ammo and see what we have left.
Indeed.
Only Ladaga knows how you have survived this long. It must be because of the superior weapons I have provided. Have you come to trade for my latest stock?
I actually not using much of the stuff you gave us. Where did you say you were when Baeloth conquered your people?
I didn't! I don't! You don't know what you're talking about. Mm. Whatever that blabbermouth Gorch has said, it's a lie!
I never said Gorch told me.
Who else would know? I mean, who else would think? That is, he's always spreading lies about me. You shouldn't believe anything he says.
Don't worry. Your secret is safe with me.
I don't have a secret. There isn't any secret.
Wink.
Only Ladaga knows how. I didn't. I don't. You don't know what you're talking about. Whatever that blabbermouth Gorch has said, it's a lie!
Wow, you fool just like a cheap tabard.
Who else would know? I mean, who else would
Don't bother.
That is, he's always spreading lies about me.
Alright, weapon.
You shouldn't believe anything he says.
Heart of the Golem plus two. There are no records of this weapon's creator. Nevertheless, its existence can be traced back among thieves and murderers to before Dale Reckoning. Its blackened blade was apparently forged from the arcane metals of an iron golem. G- giving the weapon an appearance as dark as its history. Not gonna use it though. Quarterstaff plus two. Rashad's Talon plus two. Named for Prince Rashad, former ruler of a minor principality to the east, this blade and many of the prince's possessions were taken by disgruntled palace guards after his death. The role of the guards in the unfortunate affair was never determined, but rumor has it that all died within a year, slain by this very weapon. 1d8 plus 2, slashing. Thaco plus 2. Alright, I'm not buying any of this stuff. I'll check with the Mr. Stammery. Stuttering Stanley over here. Stuttering Stanley!
Huzzah! You really should show Baloth this time. I think you might go all the way.
Are you stammering, Lass?
Maybe. Yes, I think so. Funny, I hadn't noticed.
Why do you think that is?
Since you've won so many battles, I've started hoping that these entertainments will come to an end.
That's my plan. Just hold on a little longer, and I'll free us all.
If anyone can do it, it's you.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. I better get on with it. What were you saying earlier?
Huzzah! You really should show Baloth this time. I think you might go all the way.
All the way?
Very few contestants have won 10 battles. And only once before has anyone beaten all 15. Then Baloth himself stepped in to finish the winning streak.
Only one before. How do you like my chances of taking down Baloth?
If anyone can do it, it's you.
Thanks. Well, show me what you have for sale. We need stuff. We need... Let's get, Oh, we got arrows of biting. Poison. These are good to use on, detonation. Ooh! Look at that. These are good to use against mages. What's the Quiver of Plenty? The history of this magical quiver has been long forgotten, though it likely had something to do with the inexplicable but well-documented shortage of competent fletchers during the time of troubles. Unlimited plus one arrows. Wow. Really? Gotta be pretty expensive. It's not that bad, actually. Arrows of detonation. Explodes into a huge ball of fire and shrapnel affecting all within the area. Oh, it's all, I think it's just for one arrow. Get a few of these. One d6 plus 6 piercing damage. 1d6 plus 2. 1d6 fire damage. Save versus spell for none. Oh, we don't have a save on this one, though. 1d6 plus 1 plus 2d6 acid damage. No save on it. I'll get 30. He went through them last time. Well, the fire ones. Okay, and then here we have 30 bullet plus one. Okay, we need another 20 for him, I guess. We have plus 2 now. Okay. So we got plus one, well, plus two rather, plus one, and regular. Plus two, plus one, regular, okay. Alright, so we're good on that. We got 15,000 left. Shall we see what the beholder might have to say?
It is done.
Now we're... Oh! Hello! Hogarl?
Helsingen-Etten. I see that disgusting Majer Baeloth has trapped you as well. You look competent as far as small folk go.
Did he call me an Etten? He's disgusting Magear? What does that mean? You have quite a commanding presence. How did Baeloth capture you?
He lured me away from my Huslider.
Are you what?
After a furious slag, he stepped aside and let his pet djinn bind me. Were the circumstances similar for you?
Well, I was having a pint or two, and suddenly a flash of light brought me here. It has been a frightening experience.
Forget whatever praise I may have heaped upon your tiny frame.
Okay.
Your success here must have been luck, for you certainly are no Krigger.
No what?
I shall see you again when it is time for you to die in the arena.
Oh, so he's a fire giant? What, fire giants don't take time out of their busy day to guzzle mead now and then?
You amuse me, little one. Perhaps I will feel a twinge of regret when I am forced to shatter your spine.
I think it was more reacting to that I said I was frightened. It was a frightening experience or something. Well, twinge of regret, that would be kind of you. Nothing more to say. All right. Anyone in here? Okay. Hi.
Are you prepared to face your next match? Killing something can be easy, but keeping it dead is not. Take care, lest your fallen foes rise up again to haunt you. And always remember to dispose of their bodies.
Keeping it dead is not easy. Rising up, your foes rise up to get and haunt you. Okay, maybe regenerating? Or either that or something being resurrected to fight us as undead. I don't think we're gonna go against a lich, so... I tend to think, yeah, either regenerating or... Maybe a necromancer rising, making the foes rise up again to attack once more. Well, thanks. Fire generally protects against regenerating. We have plenty of fire spells memorized, so hopefully we'll be good in that area. So.
I stand ready.
You know, but I think we want another wand of some kind.
I stand ready.
Not a problem.
So maybe then another potion of explosions? Not gonna go crazy with it because I'm not sure if that's what he means.
Yes?
And what else was I gonna get?
Certainly.
Is it worth it to keep spending? Well, we don't want anything from here. We're good on that, but I mean, that'd be, if we get this every time. Fire Giant strength is 22, Frost Giant strength 21. That'd be 2700 if we both took one. Let's take two of these. So these two will take one. And what else did I want? I was eyeing a few different things. We all have magical weapons now. Do we end up getting him this? Wait. Plus one. Right, I was gonna get him a plus two. I'm gonna take this off for a second.
I am here. It is done.
So if he were to sell it, it'll give us only 300, but it helps. Two-handed sword plus two. One d10 plus two, and attack up plus two. Yeah, let's get this for him. And sell this one. That's one of the things I was thinking of. Anything else?
Your indeed.
And what is she using? Wait a second. She's using a longsword plus one. I'd be surprised if there wasn't a longsword plus two in there. So much money. Before I do it though, let's see if there's anything else we really want. Because we're not going to have much left. A short bow plus two, long bow plus two. Still wouldn't have much left.
Yes?
This could really help. So he's just using a regular longbow.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. Get him that. I haven't even found these weapons in the in the actual game.
I am here, certainly.
Or anything else? I don't think anything else here. Case of plenty. Unlimited plus one bolts. Bag of plenty. unlimited plus one sling bullets. Although the soft cloth pouch is empty right now, there is still a powerful aura of magic surrounding it. That's awesome. Asp's Nest plus one. What is this? It's a dart. While working for the Shadow Thieves, Faerûn Foal collected thousands of small poisonous snakes to create the Asp's Nest. Faerûn took each snake, and with her powerful magic, she made a dart of each. She made the dart so that when it strikes its opponent, the snake returns to life, biting and inflicting poison damage on the target. The title Asp's Nest refers to the entire collection of darts, most of which have vanished, either destroyed in use or lost on a long-forgotten battlefield. Hit target takes 1 point of poison damage every 3 seconds for 2 turns. Save versus death negates. That go plus one damage, 1d3 plus one. That's pretty interesting, but we're not... I'm not gonna mess with bolts. Or darts, rather. Now, we don't have much money left. I don't know if there's anything else I should get. Not sure if there's anything I can get. Studded leather. No. We don't have an upgraded splint mail, I don't think. Plus one. Which I think, I'm pretty sure he's already using. Just make sure. Yep. Too bad I don't have a split mail plus two. I'd get it.
It will be done.
Oh, you're gonna... Okay. Elvesbane. Armor class plus three versus piercing and missile attacks. Plus four versus crushing. Plus three versus slashing. The Wand of Frost. Wand of Lightning. I usually don't bother with lightning. Wand of Fire. Monster summoning. These are single use. I'm gonna try saving my money. If we can't make it, if we need a little extra oomph, we'll get some of these wands, or one of these wands, actually. Well, the Wand of Frost, we can get, like, three of them if we wanted to. But we might want fire for the next battle. Magic missiles, I'm not going to bother with. 1d4 plus one, that's it. That's all that's in there. It doesn't stack. Yeah, Wand of Cloud Kill, never saw that before. Alright.
Your concern? Certainly.
I'm gonna hope that this is sufficient. Let me just look through here.
Yes?
Make sure this... What am I doing? I'm pressing O. Options. The key next was I, and that's what I've been meaning to press. It's too bad we don't have more of these Cloaks of Bravery. I would give everyone one. They're cheap. Maybe I'll check after the next battle. Maybe there'll be another one there. Alright. Well, been running for quite a while. So next episode, we're going to be fighting against things that do not stay dead in some way or another. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.